Good evening, teacher.
Hi, how are you?
Very well, teacher. Thank you. And you?
I'm okay.
That's good.
How was your day today, Irene?
Very, very hard, teacher, because I went to San Salvador.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Why, Irene? Irene la veo de lado.
Ah, right. I don't know why.
Ah, there you go. Now okay. Hoy sí la veo bien.
Thank you.
So you had to come to San Salvador, yes?
Ah, because I went to left a dejar.
Yes, to leave
a file.
Okay, all right.
Unos archivos.
A file, yes.
Uh-huh.
All right.
A file. To
the Instagram. Okay. Very good. All right, very good. All right, hi Elizabeth. No le oigo, Eli. Tiene el mic apagado. Eli.
Sorry, teacher, sorry. Good evening. Okay.
Good evening. How are you?
How's it going, teacher?
Everything's going fine. And you, Eli?
It's fine too.
All right.
It's fine too.
Okay, very good.
A little busy.
Really?
Because my daughter, she's approachment. How do you say? I don't know. My daughter is very busy because she wants to apply in the UCA
University. Aruca, uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Oh. She wants to apply. I was helping her.
I was helping her, uh-huh. Oh.
Helping her, yep.
Okay, and mm-hmm. What does she want to study?
She wants to study teacher. She like the draw, the paint, okay. Draw. Okay. She like, but the exam she gets the result to the exam, uh-huh. Ingeniería industrial.
All right, industrial engineering.
Físico, uh-huh. Matemático. A él le gusta mucho la matemática.
Oh, my goodness.
A él le gusta mucho la mate. Okay. Pero ninguna de esas creo que va a sacar, sino que siempre va a salir con sus dibujitos, creo.
Well, if that's what...
Estar ahí con ella.
Okay, very good.
Sí.
Usted apoya. Yes. Lo importante everything es que she good. Likes what she does. Very good, Elizabeth. Yes. Very nice. All right. Yeah, of course. Hi, Normita. Hi, Oscar. Hi, Eli.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, Norma. How are you?
Hi, good evening.
How was your day today, Norma?
Very tired, but yeah. Cool.
Okay, all right. Are you feeling better now, Normita?
Yes.
Okay.
I reduced a lot the pain in my shoulder.
Oh, okay, all right, okay.
But try tomorrow to go to the
therapy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Feel a noodle.
Yeah, a knot.
Knot.
Yeah.
Not on the Friday, but okay. Some.
All right, I see. Okay, guys. Hi, Oscarito. Hi, Jenny. Hi, Eli. Oscar is working today.
Yeah.
All
I'm
right.
Working.
And he's wearing a mask. Excellent, Oscar. Super. Congratulations.
You told me.
I get worried about you. Yeah, very nice. And Jenny, how was your day today, Jenny? ¿Ya no está enfermita, Jenny?
I'm fine.
Okay, all right, very good. All right, guys, a partir de ahora y los últimos días que faltan, vamos a tomar asistencia tres veces, oye. Así es que voy a tomar la primera asistencia ahorita. Normita.
Three times.
Cool, all right. Okay.
Okay.
Those are like the guidelines that we need to follow. Okay. Okay. All right, very good. So Nancy Elizabeth Larin Chavez.
Present, teacher.
Erika Lirio Perez Diaz is not here yet. Eric Mauricio Paredes. Eric. All right. Eric Mauricio Paredes Hernandez. No. Henry Vladimir del Citepas. No. Jose Luis Rivera Gutierrez is not here yet. All right. Moises Eduardo Alas Roque. No. Oscar Armando Bonilla Flores. Of course, Oscarito.
Present, present.
Excellent. Cruz Yesenia Maldonado Tejada.
Present, teacher.
Hi, Jessie. Diana Gabriela Hernández Morales. All right. Andrea María Trabanino Alfaro. No. Rodríguez Argueta. Francisca Irene Lima Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. All right. Guillermo Antonio Amaya Escobar. Jennifer Carolina Acosta Bonilla. Jennifer, thank you. Gerardo Daniel Gómez Rodríguez. All right. Norma Araceli Rivera Rivera.
Present.
Of course, Normita. Elizabeth del Carmen Salguero Romero.
Present.
Thank you. Silvia Marisol Villalta Martínez. Not yet. Silvia. All right. Verónica Lisette Soto Serna. Nope. And Nubia Araceli Cortez Amaya. All right. So guys, the other students, I'm going to take it at 9, donde antes era la primera, bueno, casi la primera. Bueno, sí, de hecho, la primera toma de asistencia, que era a las 9 de la noche, va a ser la segunda, y la tercera es antes de retirarnos, ¿verdad? Entonces, ahora son 3 veces que debo de tomar asistencia. Solo recordarles que tenemos que estar de 8 a 10, all right? Recuerde también que ahora nos quedamos un ratito más. La persona que quiera quedarse 10 minutos más después de que terminamos, solo se queda y no hay ningún problema. All right, for 10 minutes, only 10 minutos. All right, guys, very good. So yesterday we were talking about Gen X. Okay. All right, different generation, because last week we were talking about, yeah, millennials or Gen Y. Remember that it has a different name. I mean, it's the same name for the same generation. You can say millennials or you can say Gen Y, and it's the same one, okay? Why millennials? It's because they were born close to the new millennium. All right, that's why people decided to call them millennials. Pero digamos que esa es como la forma, like the nickname. All right, so the serious one is my generation Y. All right. Hi Diana. Hi Jose Luis. Hi. How are you? Hi, good evening. Para José Luis y Diana que acaban de entrar, solo comentarles que tenemos un nuevo forma ahora. Estos los 3 últimos días que nos quedan, bueno, 4 con este. Vamos a tomar asistencia 3 veces, bien al inicio de la clase, la acabo de tomar. Luego a las 9 de la noche y luego a las 10 de la noche que terminamos. All right, solo para que ustedes sepan. Pero igual, ya apunté acá que okay. You are here. All right, very good, Jose Luis and Diana. Thank you so much. All right. Okay, guys, so as I said, we were talking about, remember that you can say millennials or Gen Y is the same generation. Millennials is more like the nickname. Sin embargo, most people know, they know the generation by millennials, not by Gen Y. All right, but the serious name is Gen Y. Before the Gen Y, we have Generation X, which some of us here in this class, we belong to, all right? Before Gen X, we have the Baby Boomers, all right? And before Baby Boomers, we have many other generations. We have the Silent Generation, and then the other generations that we're not really gonna talk about it, all right? Maybe, I think, in some of our jobs, we have Baby Boomers to Millennials. All right, I don't think we have more than baby boomers down. All right, so it's like baby boomers and up, okay? So that's why we talk a little bit about that. Yesterday we were asking some questions or we were talking about the questions that we have on our book about, who just came in? All right, about some of the characteristics that Gen X has. And we were also discussing about if we have, we as like work or as employees, we have problems dealing with any other generation that is not ours, all right? Now, some of you were saying, no, you know what? I get along very well with other generations, all right? I don't have a problem. I learn from them. I learn from baby boomers. I learn from Generation X. Okay, so it's not like it's a big deal. Actually, I take advantage of that and I get along with them. Now, what about within your generation? Oscar, in your case, there are some Generation X at your workplace. Is that right?
Almost 20%.
20%. All right. Now, Oscar, and the rest, you said that they're millennials, right?
Millennials. Uh-huh.
Okay. Now, do you find yourself getting along better with your own generation or with millennials in this case? Or is the same for you?
Oh, I get along better with millennials.
Oh, really?
You know, uh-huh. I get along better with them.
All right. Tell us why, Oscarito.
Because the X generation is scattered in many, how to say, sections and departments.
Okay.
So, for example, here in my section, mm-hmm. we are three X generation, only three.
Okay.
Three people.
All right.
So, the majority are millennials, so I get along better with them.
All right, I get it. All right.
But the uh-huh. X generation are kind of individual.
Yeah.
As an individual life.
Right, yes.
I mean, not selfish or egotistical,
no.
but they live their own world. Uh-huh.
Okay, yeah. And remember, we saw that as a characteristic yesterday. All right, it differs from millennials that they want to do everything in teams. All right, so that's one mm-hmm. of like the traits or the difference between X and Y. Very good. Elizabeth, in your case, where are you guys? Elizabeth, in your case, in your workplace, you said that you have a baby boomer, right? You have baby boomers at your workplace?
Yes.
All right. Now, you, thank Elizabeth. You. Elizabeth Salguero, who do you get along better with? Baby boomers, Gen X, or millennial? Are you a millennial, Elizabeth, or a... Yeah, you're a millennial.
Yes, we have employees, millennials
okay.
too.
Okay, and you are a millennial?
Me?
Yes.
No, teacher, me, no, because I be Generation Y.
Generation Y and millennial is the same one, Elizabeth.
It's the same.
Yes, it's the same.
No.
Generation Y and millennials.
I was reading.
Uh-huh.
I was reading that the 1955, I believe.
Uh-huh. That's Gen X.
1981.
How old are you, Elizabeth?
This is Generation Y.
No, that's Generation X. I'm Generation X.
39.
All right. So you were born 1982. How old?
I was born 1981.
All right. So you're a millennial. You're a Generation Y. Yeah.
Yes.
Excellent. Yeah. All right. Okay. Now, Elizabeth, yes. Before the generation is our generation, the X one. All right. I was born 1978. Casi llego al millennial, right? Very normal. All right, now Elizabeth, in your case, Elizabeth, hi Gerardo, who do you get along better with, millennials como usted, Generation X, or baby boomers? Usted, Elizabeth Salguero, no
It depends.
It depends, okay, about what?
It depends, teacher. Yes, because the baby boomers is important because they have a the different experience that the millennium.
Yes. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay.
Some owners prefer baby women sometimes. For example, where I working, the owner prefer for administration, they prefer baby women.
Okay.
From cabinas, they prefer people younger, very younger, right. Okay. Extroverted, right. Friendly,
okay.
Funny.
Okay.
And because
fast.
The position, because and fast, yes, yes, and fast, because the position is important, because they animan.
They cheer?
Animan, cheer. They cheer the other people.
Okay, all right. Okay. Good, all right, mm-hmm. I see. Thank you, Elizabeth. Normita, in your case, all right? You have people that are Gen X, you have millennials, and I believe you mentioned that you have baby boomers, yes?
Yes.
Who do you, Norma? Norma Araceli Rivera Rivera. Who do you get better, who do you get along better with? Your same generation, baby boomers, millennials, or everybody the same?
It's very difficult because had a mix.
Okay.
But the most of people is Generation X. And nearly 30% is millennials.
Okay.
And the difference is baby boomer. All
right.
I work with all.
Right.
But I felt more better. I felt more effective.
Okay.
With the millennials.
Okay.
Because
right.
I reach in less time the thing, mm-hmm. and they share with me a different tools to improve the process.
Right.
I gain a better result.
Okay.
Working with them.
All
because
right.
Elizabeth said a one truth,
mm-hmm.
the generation X had experience,
right?
But millennials had a speed and voluntary
right.
and a commitment.
Okay,
we try to a lot of effort to learn. And,
okay.
and then you receive better the experience for the old people.
All right, I get it. Okay, very good. Thank you. All right, what about Diana in your company, Diana? All right, you have your father, which he's a baby boomer. You are a millennial. All right, I guess you might have some Generation X in your company, some people or nobody. Generation
yes,
X.
I have
okay.
some Generation X, maybe. Half of them are
all right, okay.
And the other half are millennials.
All right, so who does Diana Gabriela Hernandez get along better with?
I get along better with millennials.
Okay.
Yes, definitely, because they are more cheerful.
Yeah.
And they are like happy all the time, and they have this commitment
okay.
with the company.
And all right.
I really appreciate them for
okay.
that.
Okay, very good. Interesting, very good. What about Jenny, in your company, Jenny? All right, you are Generation X yourself. I guess there are like more Generation Xers at your company, but you also have millennials, I believe, and I don't know if you have baby boomers in your workplace. Who do you, Jennifer, Carolina, Acosta, who do you get along better with?
Better, but really? With both,
okay,
all generations, because it depends the personality to them.
Okay,
for example, I work with with both for my activities inside the work. Yes.
All right.
And baby boomers really in the company are a little.
Okay.
Yes, right. have a little people, the millennials, maybe 3 or 4 per person.
Okay, all right, I see. All right, very good.
And generation millennials, yes, baby boomers are 3 or 4 people.
Okay.
Person.
Okay.
And the millennials, yes, millennials and X.
Generation X.
Generation X, they have a lot of people.
All right.
Around.
Okay, I get it.
90%.
All right, very, very good. All right, thank you. Veronica, in your case, in your workplace, who do you get along better? Which generation, your own generation or different generations?
In my case, teacher, it's difficult. Because, for example, in my area, mm-hmm. my boss is a generation, mm-hmm. and I think he has a lot of experiences.
Okay.
But he's methodical.
All right.
And, yes. And the rest of person are millennial, and okay. then the millennial are more practical.
Right. Yeah.
But okay. in the end, I think. Yeah, I like to work with both person,
all right.
X generation and millennial,
because all right.
if we learn to work and use experiences and methodical,
I think
we can do a better work.
All right. Okay. I yes. see. All right, very good. All right, let's see. Eli, Larin, in your schools, which generation do you get along with? Do you get along better with your own generation or with another generation, Eli?
I think that the 3 generation is the same.
Okay.
Because I'm working with the 3 generation person.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And the 3 generation, they have your
there?
positive characteristics.
Of course, yes.
And then negative characteristics.
Right. Yes, of course.
I think that the same, the 3 okay. generation.
All right, interesting.
We're working the three generation.
Right, okay, very good. Irene, thank you, Eli. Irene, in your case, which generation do you get along better with?
For me, teacher, everyone generation have a different characteristic, and their characteristic is necessary for the company, because everyone aport different ideas, different okay. knowledge.
Okay.
To end is a plus.
Okay. All right. Me. Okay. Interesting. Very good. All right. What about Moises in your company, Moises? Which generation you, Moises Eduardo? Who do you get along better with?
Doesn't matter the generation.
Okay.
I prefer work with millennials.
All right. All right. Why, Moises?
Because I think that we have a lot of things in common with.
Okay.
It makes me feel comfortable.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Okay. I see. Very good. What about Guillermo in your company, Guillermo? Who do you get along better with?
For me, half the half.
Oh, half and half. Oh, tell us why.
Because the baby boomer is a methodic.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Millennium, the methodic, but faster.
All right. Okay.
Finish the work weekly.
Oh, all right. Very good. Okay.
It's what, different.
Uh-huh. Okay. Very good. What about Jose Luis or Henry in your case? Who do you like to work better with?
In my case?
Yes.
In my case, I don't have any problem, and I like to work with both generations because okay. everyone apport different things, and I like to work with all kind of generation.
Okay. All right. Very good. All right. And
in my case too, teacher.
Uh-huh.
Because but I feel more comfortable when I work in Millennium people.
Okay.
Why I feeling I learn too much when I work with X generation.
Okay. All right. Very good. And Gerardo, in your company, Gerardo, which generation do you get along better with?
For me, teacher, with both the generation, the baby boomer, and the other generation like okay. me, the millennials.
All right.
They have different ways to doing the things, but coincide.
They have similarities.
Common goals, which
common
work.
Grounds. Okay. All right. Okay.
Certain tax.
Okay. I get it. All right. And Jesse, what about in your case, Jesse? Who does Cruz Yesenia get along better with? Your own generation, with baby boomers, or with Gen X?
I think it's best working with millennials.
Yeah? Why?
I don't inside the class because I have some trouble with my computer, but I don't listen for my classmates, but I think it is best millennial because they are free, they are talking with sincerely.
Okay, sincere, they're honest.
Yes, be with honest. When they okay. don't like something, they tell you that is not that way. You have to change for another way. And it's good for me, that kinds of people.
Okay.
I work more with millennials than all another right. generation.
All right. Jesse, be nice. All right, very good, guys. I just wanted to hear your point of view and your experiences. I mean, these are based on how you feel at work, because you are the one at work, all right? Dealing with different generations and dealing with different personalities and different characteristics of everyone. Because as I have said before, even if you're a millennial, even if you're a Gen X, even if you're a baby boomer, all of these generations have their own characteristics, they have their own traits, but that doesn't mean that everyone is the same, all right? We have, I mean, maybe some of you have met people, baby boomers, that they are very tech savvy, believe it or not, all right? It depends on their characteristic, yes?
I think the baby boomers and the X generation people mm-hmm. have an advantage uh-huh. because if they try to learn about the millennials, they can do it. It could be difficult, but if they try, mm-hmm. they can do it.
Okay. All right. Okay. Yes. Interesting. All right. Very good. So today, guys, we're going to keep on talking about generations X and Y, or generation X and millennials. All right. And we're going to compare them a little bit, and we're going to study them a little bit more. All right. Also, I have included on my PowerPoint presentation, PT Oscar, a little bit about baby boomers also, because I believe that these are the three generations that Salvadorians we deal with or we have at every company. All right. Some of them are still baby boomers at work. some of most of them are Generation X, and of course the majority is also from the Gen Y or millennials. All right, so this is what we're gonna see a little bit here. Let me just show you this here. All right, so here we have compared Generation X and Y, which is, remember, Y is the same as millennials. All right, so here we have, what is a generation? Verito, can you read it please?
Okay, generation, an identifiable group that share birth years, age, location, and significant events at critical development states.
All right, very good. So the question is, what is generation, all right? And this is what they came up with. Generation is an identifiable group that shares birth years, age, location, and significant events a critical development state, all right? Yesterday, some of you were saying, well, Generation X, I think it was Irene saying Generation X is like a suffered generation because we went through the war, all right? We were older when the war was happening, all right? As in some of you millennials, they were just being born or they don't really remember about it. So the war makes a difference on everybody's life, all right? So that's a characteristic that we had to go through in a way, as well as baby boomers, all right? So those are like things that mark a generation or make a statement about a generation, all right? Significant events. Of course, for us Salvadorians, Gen X and baby boomers, one of us, a very significant event in our lives is the Civil War, all right? A significant event that happened, for example, for millennials, but they were still young in a way, is the change of the dollar, the colones, from colones to dollars, all right? All right, so that was a big change there for like the older millennials, all right? So those, like, that's a big deal. Let's see here, what else we have? Generation X, just to remind you, is from 1965, 1964, 1966. Give or take 2 or 3 years on both ends, all right? 1984, some people say, or some people go all the way to 1980, all right? So this, the years will vary depending on the research you read, the article you look into, but it's about, let's say 1965 to 1980, 1981, about those years, all right? In this case, they are saying that it's all the way to 1984. Millennials or Generation Y from 1985, according to this, to 2004, or from 1980 to now 1996, 1999. Si nos damos cuenta, la teoría cambia un poquito, pero no son 10 años de diferencia, son un par de años de diferencia in one end or the other one, all right? Your generation, I want you to think about your generation. Do you believe in generational differences? What people, places, things, events that define your generation, and what generational differences have you noticed? I want you to take a picture of this right now, please. Because I'm gonna send you to your groups right now, and I want you to talk about this. It would be nice, but we have less Generation X in class than millennials. But if you are with, for example, I'm Gen X and Jesse is Gen Y, so I can tell you about what I like, that if I believe that there are generational differences, all right? And then we can discuss that, all right? I can tell Jesse, for example, okay, what people, places, and things and events define my Generation X, okay? And then Jesse's gonna tell me what people, places, and things and events define her generation, all right? When I talk about people, I'm not only talking about your father, your mother, your brother, I'm talking about people around the world, leaders, for example, all right? Yeah, all right, so people can say, for example, in my Generation X, Monseñor Romero was there, all right, for example, all right? And I know, for example, Normita, I believe is a little bit older than me, all right? So when Monseñor Romero was killed, for example, I was only 2 years old. I was 2 years old, all right? Maybe Normita was a little bit older and she remembers a little bit more. In our generation, Monseñor Romero had something like, it was very strong, all right? even if you were not Catholic or not, that's not the, I'm not talking about religion, I'm talking about the person itself, what he meant for the country, all right? For example, so I, if you're both millennials, when I assign the groups, then you talk about, okay, so which people have influenced millennials? All right, for example, if Jesse and Diana, that I know both of them are millennials, then Jesse and Diana can come up with people that have influenced millennials. All right, this guy from Facebook, I guess, this Zuckerberg thing guy, I don't even know his name. All right, that I guess he has influenced the world, and not only Salvadorians, but the entire millennial generation worldwide, all right? Which places, which events, which things, all right? Do you understand what I want you guys to do? All right, just talk about these kind of things that has happened in your generation, all right? So, were you able to take a picture? Yes? Guys, did you take a picture? Yeah. All right, so yeah. I'm gonna assign the groups right now, so you may go back. Well, you're gonna go to your groups right now and discuss those questions for me, okay? And I want you to talk about it, really talk about it. I think it's interesting if you actually get into the topic. Hi, Williams.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
How are you? Good evening. Williams, before I send you, before I send you to your group, I'm going to share this with you so you can take a picture.
Okay.
Can you see it?
Yeah.
All right. Take a picture. And this is what this is what they are talking about right now in their groups, okay? So okay. Just kind of like... if you are in the same generation with whoever you are working with, it's okay. So both of you can talk about, do you believe if there is a generational differences, like from based on your experience at work, for example, what people, places and things and events define millennials, for example, all right? What generational differences have you noticed, all right? So those questions, okay?
Okay.
Thank you, Williams. I'm gonna sign you right now. Let me see here. Hold on, I just wanna see who I'm gonna send you to.
Okay.
All right. There you go, Williams. You may go now.
Okay.
You're good.
Thanks.
For example, in Next Generation, in speaking about sports, maybe Maradona is one.
Is, yes.
It's a sportman that defined that the X generation that identify himself. Let me see who
González
else.
Is not the Mexico González.
That will be. That will be for the let me see.
Maybe for the X, baby boomers?
No, it's for X generation. Right. Mexico is for X generation. Was in the early
80s?
In the 70s? Early 80s. 80s.
Right.
Early 80s. From sports. Mexico González, Maradona. Politicians, we told already for far right and far left.
Right.
They were very notorious on that time.
Right, yes.
We're not going to mention.
That's better. That's better.
In my case, the two persons in this area of sport is Cristiano Ronaldo and Messi. Because in this moment, this year is the boom for our.
Mm-hmm.
It's a different deportes. With the old
sportman.
Okay, that's sportman.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So let's check now what places define the your generation, Henry.
Place. I'm not sure. Place. If you talk for because in this moment I don't sure. Maybe.
Okay. When you were teen, maybe any famous place in El Salvador that you remember when you were teen?
Events, maybe, because I have this event, the problem with the finances in the United States. I think this problem was in the 2007. I don't remember because I was in the high school in this moment. But for me, it's the big event because this event, how to say, causó your effects in the economía is was to be. And the other event, maybe the storm, tropical storm in my country.
The 12th, it was a that storm didn't have a name actually. It was a I can recall, but it ended with 12. Do you remember?
This I don't know why the name, but I took the other event is the earthquake.
The 2001 earthquake.
2001. I was a leader. I care for my two sisters in this moment when happened this case.
Wow.
I have fear in this moment because I was 10. I think 10 years old in this moment.
All right. I get Oscar, I guess for us, also the earthquake of 1986.
The 86 earthquake. Did you were here?
Yes, I was here. I was here. I remember it. It was horrible.
I remember that was worse than the
2001
earthquake.
The 2001 earthquake was nothing, Henrito, compared to the 1986.
1986.
Really?
Yeah, because it was
nice. For me, the first earthquake. I like.
That's right. Yeah, of course.
Yes, in my class history, I told with the another earthquake, but only told.
Right.
Okay. That was the 1986.
Yep.
Earthquake.
How old were you, Oscar, when the 1986 earthquake?
I was 12 years old.
Yeah, I was 8.
You were 8. Okay, I was 12, and I was watching TV, and it was a black and white TV.
Of course. With no control remote.
No control remote. The TV fall.
Right.
Fall down and crashed.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, there are many events. Maybe let me see the most. For
I think the other event is the civil war. The country,
of course.
Half for X generation.
Yeah.
The peace agreement.
Right.
The peace agreement. And the end
I was
of the
not
Cold
here
war.
For the peace agreement, Oscar. I
oh,
wasn't
really?
Here. Canada already. Uh-huh.
Okay, I was in high school actually.
Yeah, all right.
I was in high school for the.
You know, it's funny
for that time.
Because we left a year before the war ended.
Almost at the end.
I know.
I see.
Right.
Oh, but in some way was good because the post-war times weren't so good at all as we expected.
Yeah, you're right.
It was, I don't know, very terrible for the family. Because it was a lot of their people.
Yeah, it was a very, it was not a nice time, Henry.
Yes.
No, it wasn't. It wasn't. But what else? Maybe let's talk about places.
Yeah,
the generation places. I will recall the Mundo Infantil. Because this was
El Plaza Alegre
was
a real place. Oscar.
The Teleférico also.
The Teleférico cool. Too. I remember Teleférico.
What happened with the Teleférico? Nice. Why is closed?
They closed it. I don't know.
They broke.
I guess.
Really?
They broke 3 times.
Okay.
The first owner, the second owner, and the third owner. And it was gone.
All right.
It was gone. Let me see what other place related to X generation. Oh.
Did you ever go? What was the first place that you mentioned, Oscar?
Mundo, Mundo Infantil, Autopista Infantil, something like that.
Autopista
Mundo Feliz.
Mundo Feliz.
Mundo Feliz.
All right. What was the name of this place that it used to be by El Paseo, by Kismet, Escalón?
Kismet,
But there
was a Plaza Alegre. That
Plaza
was
Plaza Alegre, yeah. All right, yeah.
It was a huge
toboggan. I know. Right.
Slide
of course. El Paseo del Carmen for Henrito. Yeah, cool. Sense. All right.
I see. What about you, Henry? What places do you think identify with the
millennial generations? Paseo del Carmen, he mentioned one.
Yeah, Paseo del Carmen is the ascending because I think open maybe 6 years ago, I think, because I studied in the university when beginning this place.
Okay.
The Paseo del Carmen. Mm-hmm. And the other thing, I don't know if you know, is Plaza Volcán.
Okay.
It's when you go for the Boquerón.
All right, nice place. Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I guess the Cameron. When was the Cameron open here, Henry?
The Cameron in this moment, I'm not sure because the human resource not all with the...
No, it was in 2003, maybe 2004. Uh-huh.
Oh, so
and they disrupted. They disrupt the resorts market here.
Right.
Yes. It's a millennial event.
I think so.
A millennial place.
All right.
A millennial
in the
place.
Beginning was only Salinitas.
The concept, the market concept. I mean, they disrupt the all included resort. Well,
right. Yeah.
It was new for everyone.
I think was it the first hotel when the is
all included.
Thematica all included, huh?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, so I guess that's a place.
Yes. Yeah, it is. And things, let me see what things.
Oscar, I'm sorry, you know another place that it can like resemble our generation, Oscar?
Uh-huh.
Is the Democrática. That was the first name of it, wasn't it?
Torre Democracia.
Democracia,
Was the tallest building in El Salvador. Is it still the tallest building? It is still the biggest.
So, is it?
Yeah, it is.
Torre Democracia, Enrito, is by UCA. Do you know where UCA University is?
Yes.
There is a tall building,
now Banco,
a glass building. Now it's Banco Cuscatlán. All right, so that was
the Banco Cocosan.
Let me check. What else? Well, so, the new how to say road infrastructure. The new bypasses built in the 80s.
Yeah, yeah,
I guess. Were really an event because
we didn't have any before.
It took from Soyapango to La UCA. It took the people maybe 1.5 hours to drive from Soyapango to La UCA. And after that a huge work on bypasses was made through the Boulevard Venezuela, that time was reduced to 30 minutes.
Right, okay, cool.
There were some development, but it was in the 90s.
Yeah, I guess it's almost touching the millennial. Also the Constitución Boulevard. It was built in 1993, I believe, 1990, about that. So it's post-war.
Post-war, a millennial event.
I guess so.
But it changed San Salvador because it was too. It's still there's still a lot of traffic jam.
I know it's horrible.
But it was worse. It was worse.
Was it worse? You think it was worse?
Was worse because it was a small place, a small streets, and always there were always traffic jams everywhere. And now we have traffic jams, but there's a lot of cars. There are There are more cars
situated than in the 80s. Multiplaza and the
also Pandilla. Yes.
Because
all these huge malls.
A photo. When was in I don't know how many years passed for construction in this building. When I looked at the photo, when only was in sun, it was beautiful. But in this moment, it's a look different.
Now you think it's different. And in that moment, that was a wow.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Wow. And what about things? Mm-hmm. I believe for X generation, the Ruby Cube.
Yeah, no kidding.
The Ruby Cube, The Ruby Cube. Uh-huh. I didn't play a lot. I mean, I didn't solve that.
No, me neither.
I didn't solve it. I wasn't interested. But it was a crazy thing.
Right.
Another thing from S generation is the skateboards.
Yeah.
The skateboards. Right. I saw the the some boards were narrow in the beginning in the early 80s.
Right. Yes, but, and they were longer.
Longer and narrow. And
right.
Narrow.
Yes.
And then after at the 90s at the early 90s.
Mm-hmm.
Those boards were wide.
Right.
Were wide. It was a different way to skate.
Right. You're right.
That is X generation.
Yes, it is X generation. You know, the other one is like the how do you call it? The antenna parabolica to have cable. And it was a huge thing. But you had to have money to have an antenna.
In order to have
because cable. That was very expensive.
That wasn't popular. Never went popular.
No, I guess not, but I mean some people had it.
So it's true.
But you have money maybe.
Only for rich people, man.
Only for rich people. Let me see what other things in the 80s.
Like Atari, I guess. Like Pac-Man.
The arcades.
Right.
The arcades were the 80s thing because
the video games too.
Because
but most I was of born when the Super Nintendo.
Those have a Game Boy and things to play at home. But at the beginning there were arcades and few Ataris.
And again, not many people had Ataris, Henrito, because they were expensive too.
I never played Atari.
Yeah, me neither, but yeah. Alright. And then music, Oscar. Pop music became pop music in the 1980s.
In the 80s was pop.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And romantic.
Yeah.
Bon Jovi and whatever.
And Madonna and Michael Jackson, yeah.
It's excellent news.
Of course.
By the generation, reggaeton.
I know.
So.
All right.
The generation is the most popular, the reggaeton. Yeah.
No, but the X generation music was very, very defined. I mean, very, as you said, the pop.
Yeah.
The rock and was how to say, I don't mean that it was the better epoch.
But maybe it was.
maybe it was because most of those songs are classics now.
Yeah, most of course.
From the 80s, more than the 70s, more than the 60s.
Right, yeah, totally.
Those are classics.
It was the best.
The best for music, the 80s were the best decade for music.
Right.
I think the song spoke the lies in this moment.
The what?
The song spoke of the lies this moment.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, very good. Interesting, guys. So many things, huh? Oscar, to recall.
Many. We're missing. Okay, we're missing many, many more things, places, events. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
In this moment, Oscar, remember all the places.
I know, Oscarito.
Let me see. What generational differences have you noticed, Henry? Between millennials and X generation.
Maybe the notice is the new technology we're using in this moment, because the technology is advanced a lot. Because maybe in the yes generation, I see the, how to say this, caricatura.
The smartphones?
Cartoon, los cósmicos, I think.
The cartoons,
The cartoon, the cósmicos.
The cartoons,
The cartoon, in this cartoon, they represent what the has go to the future. Why in this moment
Hi Silvita.
Hi teacher.
Hi,
sorry Silvia. I am late.
That's okay, Silvia. Were you able to go to your group or not?
I don't understand. It's really very, very, very.
Oh, very hard.
Yes. Repeat, please.
Yeah. Were you able to get into your group?
Yes. I don't know what is the group where.
All right. Okay, but don't worry, Silvita.
Send me.
Okay. Everybody's coming back right now. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, that's okay. Hi, Berito. hello teacher, guys. Hi.
I have a problem with exercise in the platform. I send you in the WhatsApp tomorrow.
Yes, please send it.
Okay, thank you.
All right, guys, we're back. I wanna let's see what the you guys discussed about on your groups. But before that, I need to take attendance. Para los que acaban de entrar, no hace, o sea, entraron despuesito de la hora, solo comentarles que vamos a tomar la asistencia 3 veces. Una al inicio de la clase, bien al inicio de la clase, la segunda ahorita y la última al final de la clase. All right, así es que me colaboran con eso, por favor. Voy a tomar la segunda attendance porque ya tomamos la primera. All right, Nancy Elizabeth Larín Chávez.
Present, teacher.
Erika Lirio Pérez Díaz. All right, Eric Mauricio Paredes Hernández. Henry Vladimir del Cid Tepas.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Henrito. All right, José Luis Rivera Gutiérrez. José Luis Rivera Gutiérrez. Oh, todavía están entrando. José Luis.
José Luis, teacher, José Luis estaba en la práctica conmigo.
Sí, ahí está, pero quizás se
oh, bueno.
Se levantó por ahí. Gracias, Guillermo. All right, ahí lo vemos. José Luis Rivera Gutiérrez. Moisés Eduardo Alas Roque.
Present.
Oscar Armando Bonilla Flores.
Present.
Cruz Yesenia Maldonado Tejada.
Teacher.
Diana Gabriel Hernández Morales.
Present.
Andrea Maria Trabanino Alfaro. Williams Alexander Rodriguez Argueta. Williams, thank you, Williams. All right. Francisca Irene Lima Hernandez. All right. Guillermo Antonio Amaya Escobar.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Jennifer Carolina Costa Bonilla.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Gerardo Daniel Gómez Rodríguez.
Present.
Norma Araceli Rivera Rivera.
Present, teacher.
Elizabeth del Carmen Salguero Romero.
Me present.
Thank you. Silvia Marisol Villalta Martínez.
Present.
Verónica Lizeth Soto Serna.
Present.
Ann Nubia Araceli Cortés Amaya. All right. Oh, very good. We have a good group today. All right, guys. Very good. So let's see what you guys talked about here. On the first question or the first thing I showed you actually here. Hold on. Your generation, do you believe in generational differences? All right. Williams, do you believe in generational differences? Yes or no?
Yes.
Why?
Because sometimes we have a big difference or a big mark difference because we have different events whose pass in, for example, in the past generation, in the actual generation,
all right.
So in my generation. So sometimes the difference are big, really big.
Okay.
For example, about the technologies difference.
Right. Okay, very good. Okay, very good. Thank you. Normita, do you believe in generational differences, yes or no? And tell us why or why not.
I see or believe that difference exists.
Okay.
In generation, but depending for the tolerance mm-hmm. and the respect.
Okay.
How to you management that different with the person.
Okay.
And I discuss with the I discuss with Moises.
Okay.
For example, I had a better friends for the baby boomerangs.
Okay.
And I had a relationship with them.
All right.
But I had a knowledge what thing I hope for them and what thing no.
Okay, and I see.
Unacceptable that
okay.
And I live with them.
Okay.
And another extern, I had a good friend for millennials.
Mm-hmm.
And I had a good relation with him too.
Okay, all right.
But with the same basis.
All right.
The relation.
All right, I get it. Very good. All right. Let's see. Oscar, what do you think? Generational differences, yes or no? Why or why not?
Yes, there are generational differences.
Uh-huh.
Because the environment when in which you grow up
mm-hmm.
is influenced by the culture.
Okay.
And by the events of that generation.
Mm-hmm.
So okay. Someone was telling yesterday that the values, yes, yeah. I believe was Yesenia.
Okay.
Telling that the values are maybe in this country are the same values, but some how to say the environment change.
Mm. Right.
I mean, in this case, with the gap between the X generation and the millennials, for me is the technological the information technological advances.
Okay.
The smartphones and the
right.
And all the stuff related to the communication.
All right. Communication. I get it. Very good.
Uh-huh.
All right.
So there are differences.
Okay. Very good. Guillermo, do you believe there are generational differences? Guillermo?
Yes, teacher.
Okay.
We, José Luis,
uh-huh.
shared for the different For example, the use the technology.
Right.
Different leadership.
Okay. All right. Very good. All right. Let me see. Jesse, okay. Generational differences. Do you believe there are generational differences? Jesse, hola, Jesse. Jesse, you're frozen. Jessita, your microphone is off.
Hello, teacher.
Hello.
Excuse me.
That's okay. All right. Do you believe in generational differences?
Yes, I believe because I see the generation differences.
Ah, tell us how, Jesse.
I live with different generation in my home.
Okay.
And the people are so very different. In some cases, I don't understand they. And in some cases, I feel so lazy.
Okay.
And I feel, I don't know about here because in some moment I don't understand the generation before the baby boomers are so difficult people for me.
All right. Okay. Now in your
for me too.
Guillermo. All right. Yeah.
Because the generation inside the one square.
Okay.
That they know in the last time about 80 years, they want to continue living in the same way.
Okay. Yeah.
And for today, it's very different.
All right.
Because this is the reason I believe in the difference of generation.
All right. Now, Jesse, in the house you live in, there are many, many, many different generations, I guess.
Yes, I am the younger people in my house.
Okay.
Yeah, the other people are 83 years.
All right.
65 years.
Right.
And I'm the younger people. In some moment, I feel so very bad.
All right. Are there other millennials like you in the house?
No.
Only you, Jessita. Oh no, Jesse.
Yes.
All right.
Yes, but this is the reason that in so coming I use my time in the social media.
Oh, Jesse. All right. Okay. You need to
because that is my work. Right. That is my word, and it's so difficult adapt your life mm-hmm. with the life of the
mm-hmm. Right.
This is a goal in the religious life you have to overcome. Right. But in my case, I don't overcome for that goal.
All right. Okay, Jesse, I get it. All right. Very good. Okay. Thank you, Jesse. What about the next question? It was about what people, this is interesting, what people, places, things, and events define your generation? All right, let's see. Normita, Jennifer, Oscar, me, who else is Generation X in this class? Only Norma, Jesse, Oscar, and myself? Or are there more? Generation X, not anymore? Only Oscar?
Me, teacher.
No, Elizabeth, you're not Generation X.
I was born in 1981.
Por eso usted es millennial.
No. I don't remember what is the el año, the year.
Sí, es que los millennials decimos que empezaron como en los 80, del 80 para allá ya es millennial. All right, por eso le digo así, como que casi. Pero si usted se nos quiere unir al grupo, no nos enojamos, all right? Very good. That's okay. All right.
Teacher, so the 14th September, I arriving my 40. Yeah, sorry.
All right. Sí, usted también está en el borde. All right.
The next.
Oh, my
the next week.
Next week. Yeah, 2 weeks from now. All right.
No,
good.
Next week. No, 14.
In 2 weeks. 14, yes, in
September
14. Yeah, in 2 weeks. Okay. So let's see. Normita. Moises, Normita, Jennifer, Oscar, and me. All right. Norma, tell everybody about the people, all right, that influenced the X generation. Only people right now, Norma, okay?
Only one people.
No, only talk about people that influenced our generation. Not only one person. About
everybody, okay.
But only people right now.
I think that Mother Teresa of Calcutta was a good influence for our generation. She put in evidence that the poor needs for the child's without need to live, and she convinced people with position and money to give resources to work with that people.
All right.
It was a good influence for my generation.
All right, very good. All right. Oscar, tell us about another person. From or other people from our generation, Oscar.
I was telling that the some people from the far right and the far left in El Salvador, and Pope Francisco.
Juan Pablo II. Juan Pablo II. All right.
The Pope Juan Pablo II. John Paul II will
be. Right. That's right. Yes.
Paul the second, and what else? People, well, I forgot.
All right, you mentioned Maradona from the sports.
Maradona and Mágico González in El Salvador.
All right, very good. All right, very good.
Those were exoneration. Monsignor Romero also.
Also.
Talking about religious.
Right,
religious.
Yeah.
And who else? Let me check. Very famous in music. Well,
in music, many people. All right. Very good. Jennifer, do you have someone else from our generation?
Yes, Mr. President Duarte.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Like about politics. Yes.
Gandhi, too.
All right. Okay.
Because he fights to the human resources in the India.
Human rights. India. Okay.
Human rights in India. The same to Norma Teresa de Calcutta. And for example, in actor or actress. For example, Tom Cruise.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Yes. Elegant. Yes.
All right. Uh-huh.
And the singers. Let me see. The Kiss.
Okay, yeah, that rock band, all right, yes, of course, all right.
The rock band, the Kids.
Okay, very good.
Let me see another. There's a lot of people, but right. Don't remember.
All right, very good. All right, very nice. What about millennials? Millennials, tell us about people that have influenced millennials. Millennials, nobody's gonna say anything about the people that have influenced your lives or your generations.
Hey, for me, teacher,
The people that influenced in my life is Holly Vaquita.
The what?
Yes, okay. Holly Vaquita. She are don't know about a lot of people, but in the religious life is a good life because she are
she is
indigenous.
She's
an indigenous. All right. Yes. And she is celebrated in her, I don't know, that they are talking different about us. She is African peoples.
All right.
Yes. And she had a good life. And when she got to another place because the father there is seller she and she are part of by the bill for the women's.
All right.
Yes, and that is a good life for me.
Okay.
It's a holy too. It's a holy in our church.
Okay.
And another people that I mark my life is the Holy Alberto Hurtado is a Chileno, a Chilean, but he work a lot of by the poor people.
Okay.
He is a lawyer.
A lawyer.
But yes, he is a lawyer, but he is working all the time by the poor people.
Okay.
And he wins in some, I don't know, some cases about the poor people that the people don't can pay.
They can't pay.
They can pay the money for that cases. Oh. And he win that cases.
All right. Cool.
It's another good life for
all right,
me.
Very good. And, all right,
And I agree with Oscar too. I love the holy Juan Pablo II.
All right.
Papa.
Okay.
Because for me is the best life that I know. Because it's I know, I see in person, and I tell I listen, that is holy, is a gift for me.
Okay.
It's a good life. Teach me all about the lies because I don't know about the lies.
Okay.
In that moment.
All right. Very good. All right. Very good. Okay. Another millennial that you can tell us about who has influenced your generation.
Okay, this girl maybe is not part of our generation, but she's influenced our generation.
Okay.
And she's Malala.
Okay, yes, of course.
I love her because she's fighting for the human
rights.
Yeah, human rights.
Yeah.
About women's in.
Right.
Yeah, it's great. It's a big deal because not as easy overall in this culture where the women, where women don't have
the any, right for education.
Yeah, so she find, I don't know how to say contracorriente.
Against everything.
Okay, so like that, and she's a big example.
Right.
When you can do, when you have a hope, or when you hope how something happens, if you fight about that, maybe happen.
Right.
But you don't try. You don't know if
right.
What ball or not is.
All right. Okay.
Malala is millennial.
Yeah, Malala is millennial.
Malala is millennial, Williams.
And I want to hear about.
Yeah. I think so, she's like 25 right now, I think, isn't she? About that? So she's millennial.
Like 24, 25.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so she's a great example of a millennial.
Uh-huh.
She started when she was really young.
Yeah, she began when she was like a girl. Very
she was 12. She was 12 when she was shot.
Yeah.
Right. About that. All right. Very good, Williams. All right. Millennials, any other person that has influenced your generation? Diana, anybody in mind?
I don't know if I am being shallow, but I think that cars, they have influenced like our generation. Maybe like Britney Spears or Christina Aguilera or Justin Timberlake. I'm so sorry
for being so
shallow, but like the pop, like the pop culture, has been influenced by them.
All right. Yeah, of course, it has influenced them. Diana is part of the
millennials.
Yeah, they are. Very good. All right. Eli, Larin, or anybody else, Irene, Verito, about millennials or people that have influenced your generation?
I think
my favorite group were the Backstreet Boys.
Oh,
in my younger.
Right. Okay.
Yes, they were like a big deal.
Of course. Very good. Yeah. Yes. All right. Very good. Vero, what were you gonna say? Thank you, Eli.
I'm not fan of the some social media, but I think in, for example, Mark Zuckerberg.
Okay. Yes.
Yes, because they create a famous social media.
That's right. Yes.
Yes.
Very good, Vero. Very, very nice, Vero. All right. Anybody else? Thank you, Verito. Yes.
Diana?
Steve Jobs. Also, right.
Our generation.
Yeah. Of course. All right. Very good. Okay. What about the other one? Is it places? Oscar, do you have it by do you have it close? Is it places after people? All right. What about places? Generation Xers. All right. Mention places to these millennials. All right. What place has influenced our generations? Normita, Jenny, Oscar, and me. When we talk about places, which places have influenced our lives or our generation?
The Mundo Feliz in Plaza Alegre.
Yay!
And the Mundo Feliz used to be named like Autopista Infantil, something like that in the area.
Yeah.
I went to my song.
Very good, Jenny. Yeah, me too. El teleférico, you see?
Teleférico.
Yeah. The teleférico is aquí. Yeah. All right, very good. Another place, Norma? From our generation, Norma?
In our generation, teacher, go to the circus.
Okay. All right. Yes, you're right.
Metrocentro, too, teacher.
Also, Metrocentro. Metrocentro was a big deal. It was new.
It's not new. In our generation, the generation X built the Metrocentro.
Yeah, of course.
Mm-hmm. Enjoy more with the family, go to the beach.
Right, yeah, you're right. All right,
Salinitas Club.
Salinitas before the Cameron Resort. Very good.
Yes.
All right, yeah.
Before, yes.
Yes.
Okay. I visited.
Yeah, you know
Salinitas
what?
Club.
You know, yeah, no kidding. Uh-huh. Another place that I think many people went to when we were like, it was Los Planes de Renderos.
El
Saburo Irao also.
Saburo Irao.
Zoologic.
The zoo, donde habían animales a long time ago.
All right. Sí, long time ago, teacher. Because right. when I visit the zoo, it's the monkey, yeah. many kinds of monkeys.
All right, very good. Okay, Consuma. Consuma. Yeah, I think so. Ya yeah. Está. Yeah.
Yeah. Bye, bye, Consuma. Is that millennial?
El Cerro Verde.
El Cerro Verde also, Berito. Yeah, you're right. Okay, millennials, what about places that identify your generation?
Uh-huh. The Sivers Cafe.
Ciber, yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Yep. Very hey. Good. Good one, Merito. Excellent. Uh-huh. Another one.
Starbucks.
It's Starbucks. What? That's now. That's not even millennial. Creo que es todavía más reciente todavía.
Yeah.
All
yep.
right. What Tunco other Beach. Places? Excuse me?
El Tunco Beach.
Beach. Yes. All right.
Yeah. That, yes. The shape of coins or money. I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah. The switch of dollars to from colones to dollars, yes. Yeah. All right, yeah. What else, millennials?
The national flag at El Boquerón.
Okay, yeah. All right, yes. Very good. Oh, it's raining here.
Yeah, too, and really, really hard.
Yeah, it is raining super hard. All right.
In my home, too?
Yeah.
This place in the volcano.
That's the. A Henrito said it. La Plaza Volcán, right? Yes. Yeah. All right. Yeah. Very good. Henry was mentioning another one. Henry, can you tell your classmates? El Paseo.
Paseo del Carmen.
Paseo del Carmen, he said. All right. Yeah.
Also, Multiplaza.
Also,
La Gran Vía.
Yeah.
Like Multiplaza and La Gran Vía. It was like a really big deal.
Of course.
Benihana's.
Yeah, Benihana. All right, very good. Okay, what about, what was the other one? It was not places, it's things. Uh-huh, let's talk about things that influence our generation. Oscar, you were mentioning a couple.
Uh-huh, the Rubik Cube. Uh-huh. The Rubik Cube and the...
El Jack.
What was the one? No.
I used to play Jack.
Uh-huh. Okay, let me see. Let me remember the cube. The BMX bikes. Because they were... was something new. Something like to
yes,
play
skate.
Like a skate. Uh-huh. The skateboards. We were
Capirucho.
Talking about that.
All the traditional games. The yo-yo and the trompo and then... Ule and all those, uh-huh. right? Cool. All right, very good. Normita, can you think about things that influence our generation?
That women play soccer, teacher. Okay. In our time.
Okay, very good. All right. All right.
Play the soccer and play the football American.
Yes.
All right. Very good. All right, millennials, what are things that have influenced your generation? Like things iPhone. In general. Uh-huh.
The iPhone.
iPhone.
The cell phones.
Cell phones.
Tablet.
Computer, tablet, everything that is techie. Yes. All right. Okay. All right. Generation X, what about events that influence our lives? Events.
Events,
no, eventos.
The peace agreement.
The peace agreement, the war, even, all right, also.
The end of the Cold War.
Yes.
The Civil War, the ofensiva final.
Yes.
Yes. Events, uh-huh. What else?
And a more natural disaster. Teacher too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Earthquake too.
1986 earthquake.
Yes.
Yeah.
In the high school. The first years in the high school.
Oh my goodness. Okay.
And I remember because it's the closet in my room.
Oh really?
Yes. Yes. Oh. Just in my room. I am scared for this moment.
Yeah, of course. Very good. Anything else?
Yes, and the Darío building, yes.
Yeah.
Destroy the real building. And the building to Sima.
Okay.
The people tell about the in this time open to in two parts and after close the building.
All right. Okay. Very good. All right, very good. For millennials, what about events that have influenced your generation?
Shopping online, teacher.
Yes, shopping online.
Yes.
Shopping online.
Yeah, for sure.
YouTuber.
Yeah. And the new earthquake, 2000.
Yeah. 2001. Uh-huh, very good. Uh-huh, millennials, any more events that have influenced your life?
11 September.
September 11th, yes. Yeah. Anything else?
Delivery service.
All right.
Delivery
service. Okay, very good. Mm-hmm. What else?
Uber.
Uber. Oh my goodness.
Netflix.
No, pero eso ya no es millennial.
This is the new.
Uh-huh.
New age.
Uh-huh.
No, teacher. De.
Events or events?
Events. All right. Sí, yo creo que Netflix y Uber son más recientes todavía.
Yep. For me, Microsoft.
Microsoft. All right. Yeah. Very good. Yes, Gerardo. Very good. What else?
Global network?
Yeah, I guess so.
Globalization?
Yes, all the social apps too, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
The apps. All the apps.
Very good. All right. Very nice. Interesting. All right, guys, let's continue here. I'm going to share this with you. Let me see. All right. We have some differences between baby boomers, Generation X, and Generation Y. Normita, can you read about baby boomers?
Okay, baby boomers asset, anxious to please, challenge the status quo, good at seeing the big picture, good team players, mission service oriented, will go the extra mile, problem solvers, and liabilities, process oriented, can be self-centered, rarely commitment long term, often judging a lot of other activities and resent not being available to make decision about how to do their work.
Okay. All right, very good. So here, these are things or traits about baby boomers, all right? Now, you guys work with baby boomers. If you look at this list, do you agree or disagree?
I agree with you.
Okay, why?
Because the baby boomers, the characters to them, sometimes is closer.
Okay.
Yes. And I work with them in my when I was young.
Okay.
And when they decide about the whatever thing, don't change the opinion.
Okay.
And I didn't do it my opinion about the about the new ideas sometimes.
All right. Okay. Very good. Okay. Anybody else about baby boomers? Do you agree or disagree with the list of things that we have here? You're okay?
Almost don't know them. I don't have any opinion about
now, Oscar, but if you think about your dad, your mom, do you see any of these lists in their characteristics, for example?
Some are the right ones. Half right. And half.
Okay.
Half assets and half liabilities.
Liabilities. All right, very good. Okay. Yeah, all right, very good. Now here we have Generation X, and here we have Generation Y or Millennials. Do me a favor. Take a picture of this one right now. Generation X. All right, now take a picture of Generation Y. All right, guys, are you ready? Take a picture of Generation Y.
Yes, teacher.
All right. Did you take the both pictures? Yeah? ¿Te lograron tomar las dos fotos? Sí.
The second, no, teacher.
Oh, I'm sorry, Norma. All
yes, right. Teacher.
No, sorry. Thank you.
All right. All right, so this is what I want you to do. Now you have Generation X and Millennials, all right? And the idea is to compare them. Look at the assets and the other things that we have, or all the characteristics and things that we can say about both generations, and try to compare them with your partner and see what are the differences and the same or similarities that we can have between one generation and the other one, all right? So try to put them like together so you can see and say, okay, yeah, you know, these are like things that are the same. These are things that can be different. And if you agree or not, if you can also say, I feel like I am like that, all right? Or no, you know what? I am an ex, I belong to this generation, but I don't feel that I am this way, all right? So talk about the differences and the similarities that we can have among generations, all right?
All right.
Thank you.
Good evening.
Hi, Eli. Hi, Eli. Hi, Eli. Hi, Eli. ¿Me escucha, Eli? Eli, ¿me escucha? Hi, Moises. Hi, Moises. Yes. Se salió, Moy.
Yeah, because I had some trouble with the connectivity. But all right. I will.
Who were you working with Norma?
With Norma and Irene.
All right, let me just find the group again.
Thanks.
Okay.
Is it raining by your house?
No, this is the, no.
All right, okay. No, it's raining by my house and many other houses, but I wasn't sure if it's raining in your house.
No.
Okay, all right. Here you go, Moises. There you go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Teacher.
Hi.
Teacher.
Hola, Eli.
My classmate, Silvia and Eli Ladin. They didn't listen to me.
I'm going to send you to another group, Eli, right now, okay?
Okay. It's about the raining, teacher.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, it is raining really hard.
And that this have to be treated with careful, carefully, because I don't know if you heard the president or I don't know if this Choli person said that someday the people won't need to go to the university because we have YouTube, and I think that's a really dangerous point of view. You know, because the knowledge is there, but you need someone who gives you this structure and this I don't know,
knowledge.
This path to follow. You know.
Yeah.
It's like this English classes, for example. You could have learned taking like. Classes on YouTube, but it's not the same.
Yeah, and they don't investigate about the topics. They only Google.
Mm-hmm.
They
think that they know everything because they Google it, and that's not.
Yeah,
that's
not some say, no, I don't need it to know about because when I need. I can Google it.
Yes, I don't need a lawyer. I don't need an accountant. I don't need an engineer because I can Google it.
Because I need it, I can find.
It. Yes, and that's really dangerous. You know, that is like
a big dangerous first.
Yes, it's dangerous. It's interesting.
Yeah.
So, sorry.
What happened?
I don't know. So, guys, have you found like a lot of common things between Gen X and Gen Y, or more differences?
More difference? No.
Uh-huh. Yeah, we have more.
Yes.
More differences.
There are more differences that are like things.
Yes.
All right. Like what, Diana?
I think that the most important part is that Generation X is having this way of working that is like self-centered.
Okay.
And they are like thinking about themselves, and they are not thinking that like in team working.
Okay. All right. Okay. Anything else, William?
Yeah, we was talking about technologically
savvy, technologically savvy. All right.
The difference is because when this generation have access to all technologies and all things, and a different the past generation who don't have, for example, to read more, we was need to read more, like the actual generation, and we was more investigative.
Like you research more, investigate more. Okay.
Yeah, mm-hmm. a different the generation who's grow into the technologies, because you only Google it some topic and you have a lot of information.
Right. Okay.
We have to read a lot of books
to get little information. No, I'm kidding.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. All right. Very good. Anything else?
No, teacher.
All right. All right. Let's see. Who's sharing the screen right now?
Jenny.
All right, Jenny. Can you show me the previous slide?
Previous?
The previous one. Yeah.
Let me see.
She's tech savvy, you know.
Yes, she is.
Yeah, she is.
She's stunning because she always shares.
I know.
Her screen with me.
I know. All right. So here we have that we are Generation X, enthusiastic, flexible, direct communicators, eager to learn, very determined, like to get things done, results before process, and technologically savvy. Yeah, I guess the Generation Xers that are closer to millennials, we try to become a little bit more tech savvy than the younger Generation X. But even you can find that. Remember that yesterday we were saying that technology began on our generation, all right? Now you guys shaped it up better, all right? And you were born with it. We were working our ways through it, all right? But yeah, we have that. Cynical and skeptical, this like rigid work requirements, impatient, people skills can be, all right, mistrust institutions, all right, very good, all right, okay, very good. I guess you guys are happy on the generation that you belong to, right, Diana and Williams?
Yes, I am really happy.
All right, very good. Okay, guys, we're gonna go back because it's almost time to go.
Okay,
thank you. All right, guys, let's talk quickly about some of the things that both generations X and Y, they have in common. Anything that you could find on the slides of the information that I shared with you? any common grounds, any things that are alike between generations, comparing them? Anything anything that we can compare with with both generations, or are they totally different?
And both generation is important, teacher.
All right, but what about characteristics? Are they very alike or very like different?
There are something in common.
Okay, all right.
Uh-huh.
For example, technological software.
Savvy, both of them are. All right, okay, what else? Anything else?
Optimist positive.
Right. Okay. Very good. All right. All right, guys. Very good. I'm going to take the last attendance so I can let you go. All right. Nancy Elizabeth Larin Chavez. Eric Alirio Perez Diaz.
Present, teacher.
All right. Eric Mauricio Paredes Hernandez. Henry Vladimir Del Citepas.
Present, teacher.
Jose Luis Rivera Gutierrez. Jose Luis. All right. Moisés Eduardo Alas Roque.
Present.
Oscar Armando Bonilla Flores. Oscarito.
Present, present.
Thank you. Cruz Yesenia Maldonado Tejada.
Present.
Diana Gabriela Hernández Morales.
Present.
Andrea María Trabanino Alfaro. Williams Alexander Rodríguez Argueta.
Present.
Francisca Irene Lima Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Guillermo Antonio Amaya Escobar.
Present, teacher.
Jennifer Costa Bonilla.
Present, teacher.
Gerardo, thank you. Gerardo Daniel Gómez Rodríguez.
Present.
Elizabeth del Carmen Salguero Romero.
Present.
Silvia Marisol Villalta Martínez.
Present.
Thank you. Verónica Lizeth Soto Serna.
Present.
Ann Nubia Araceli Cortez Amaya. All right, guys, I'm going to let you go. Si alguien se gusta quedar al final de la clase, so we can chat for 10 minutes, I'm going to be here, all right? Los demás, bye. Okay. I'll see you tomorrow. Mañana, 8 en punto. Bye, guys. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye, teacher. Bye. Thank you.
Bye. Good night.
Bye, everybody.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye. Miss,
hi,
I had a question.
Yes, Jessie, what's your question? Hi.
I finished all the platform, but the final exam don't mark in color red. Why?
You finished the exam completely?
Completely, yeah.
The final exam is in gray.
Yes, all is good.
Okay. La barra, me está diciendo de la barra. ¿Le
sí,
sale
no
gris?
Se marcan. Yes.
¿Le sale gris?
Sí, me sale gris.
Ok, ese es el color del final exam.
Oh, ok.
All right. If you notice, Jesse, for the sections, is light red. Para
yes.
Creo que el midterm es como ocre. ¿Ya?
Gris sí, me sale a mí.
Ah, bueno. Pero sí, el examen final, la barra le sale gris, está perfecto. Ese es el color de la gráfica del examen final.
Oh, bueno. Ah, pues ya yes. Terminé.
Excellent. Super.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Miss.
Very good.
See you tomorrow.
A las 8, Jesse.
Okay. Yeah.
Thank you. Bye. Good night.
See you. Bye. Yes. God bless you.
God bless you too. Hi, Elizabeth.
Teacher.
in the question about yesterday. Uh-huh. It was in 2.2. I get a mistake.
Uh-huh.
Can you hear me?
Uh-huh.
I get a mistake because I write in the anyway, I write in the other way. And always got a mistake. 2.2 es, yo me equivoqué, le había hecho 3.2.
¿Y se acuerda? La tarea es la 2.2. Esa es la
2.2
tarea.
Es.
A ver, ahorita, permítame, quiero verla. Sí. All right, ya la vamos a ver, permítame.
¿Cómo es que la vamos a completar?
Solo déjeme verla porque no me recuerdo exactamente cuál es, pero ahorita la veo. Deme un ratito. Todo el ejercicio, Eli.
Pues solo una, deme. Solo una, dígame cómo se hace. Porque en todas me da error, pero con una que me diga yo lo hago.
Vaya, ahorita. Te la voy a poner aquí en el chat, Jessica. I mean, Eli, perdón.
Ah, ver.
Ahí está. Mire cómo, esa sería la número uno, Eli.
There are problems
not only with
you put children. Technology before wait. Let me check. There are problems not only with the children, but los dos va a poner.
Uh-huh.
Los dos vamos a poner.
Ahí está la otra, Jessie, que le puede ayudar ahí. But... Copy them, Jessie. Eli, okay, porque estoy diciendo Jessie. Eli, perdón.
Jessie es gone.
Sí, como se quedó al final también, okay. I'm sorry. Aquí está la otra, that would be number three.
Lo dos habría que poner. I think that we have to choose one.
No, because it's either both. I mean, you're using not only but also.
But the example say you choose not only or but also.
Rewrite sentences using not only but also, dice la instrucción. Tiene que usar ambas, porque son pair conjunctions, no puede ir una sin la otra. Uh-huh. Entonces aquí ya le puse, esta es la número uno, mire Jessy. This is number one. Esta acá is number two.
Uh-huh.
And this is number three.
Yes, I checked the picture.
Uh-huh.
Ah, okay. Ahí es donde tengo problemas.
Okay. Vamos a ver esta.
Ajá. Uh-huh.
Para que you can get help here, Ellie. Hold on. This is the one. She not only was upset but also angry.
What is upset, teacher?
Upset like molesta.
Ah, upset. Okay.
All right, and this one, Ellie.
Okay, tomorrow I will try to complete.
Yeah, that's the last one, Jessie. Ellie. They not only need food but also medicine.
Mm-hmm. Okay, right. Teacher. Okay. Thank you.
You're very welcome, Ellie.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, teacher. Bye.
Bye.